activist Arvind Kejriwal met SP Uday Kumar, the man who's leading the Kudankulam agitation at an undisclosed location a while ago. Remember, Kejriwal arrived in Kudankulam yesterday. Uday Kumar was whisked away by his supporters minutes before he was to surrender yesterday. Arvind Kejriwal's meeting with SP Uday Kumar, very, very significant there. Premada now joins us on the phone line with more details. Premada, many would say that Arvind Kejriwal's support right now to this agitation could add fuel to the fire. Just take us through what really transpired in that meeting between the two. What sort of support has Kejriwal promised to the man leading anti-nuclear power protest?
The first strategy of Uday Kumar and his team was take this protest beyond Nithangarai, beyond Tamil Nadu, and they wanted a national leader to support them. They wanted a national face to support them, and that's why Arvind Kejriwal has now come and associated himself with this protest. Yesterday he met the protesters and also made an appeal to Uday Kumar, urging him not to surrender before the police, because the movement will die down if at all he surrenders. And now today the meeting is just taking place. Even they are as they are talking, the meeting is taking place at an undisclosed location. My sources are telling me both of them are discussing on the strategy, how to make this movement bigger, how to take it to the national level. And Arvind Kejriwal has pitched in the complete legal support to Uday Kumar, because there are 300 cases pending against him in Tamil Nadu. So he's promised to give him complete legal support to deal with these cases and also to take on the authorities, not just in the state but also in the center. Now the biggest question is, will the strategy of surrender actually help the protesters or not? While Arvind Kejriwal is urging Uday Kumar not to surrender, we are being told that Uday Kumar personally feels at this point of time, when the situation is quite volatile, if he doesn't surrender, then things could become really worse. So they are planning their strategy on what should be done. I'm getting information that by afternoon, some of the other Tamil leaders might also arrive here at Irindakarai. They might have a joint meeting with Arvind Kejriwal, and of course Uday Kumar, from his undisclosed location, will also be taken into concern, and then they will arrive at the final decision whether to court arrest or to continue with the protest and wait for the police.
Right, but will it be correct to say, Premvada, that Arvind Kejriwal and his India Against Corruption now supporting this movement, it's given a fresh impetus to this agitation, and though it baffles many, what really is the meeting ground for the two movements? Because Kejriwal's movement was anti-corruption, and now this is against, clearly, agitation against the setting up of a nuclear power plant. Is this an anti-establishment clause that has really brought together the two sides?
Definitely, definitely, if you rightly put it, it's definitely the anti-establishment thing that brought both these leaders together. And also for Arvind Kejriwal, probably he's expanding his realm of activism beyond corruption, now against Kudankulam plant also. Even while talking to us yesterday, Arvind Kejriwal made an allegation that he's suspecting that there could be some kind of corruption hidden in the Kudankulam power plant also. He claims that the technology used in the plant is quite outdated, and he questioned the government for purchasing that technology. So he has kind of merged his movement with this movement now, as in they do function independently, but though the ideologies have been merged and the support groups have been formed for each other to complement. So this is basically an attempt to take this protest beyond Tamil Nadu, make it bigger. For Arvind Kejriwal, it's about expanding his realm of activism, and probably then he enters politics to ensure that he is against anti-establishment and takes on every issue. For Uday Kumar, he definitely needed the support of a national personality, a face from the national level who could support him and give him that cover that's very much needed now that he's got it. So both of them are making this a bigger movement, and the movement which was so far confined to one state has probably gained momentum now.
Alright, Arvind Kejriwal says corruption in Kudankulam nuclear power plant project. He's lent his support to this agitation. In fact, it was after he persuaded Uday Kumar that he refused to court arrest. He was whisked away by his supporters. Interesting developments there in Kudankulam. Remains to be seen how State Chief Minister handles the situation.